Hey everybody, I'm happy, I mean, 4th of May, happy 4th of May, July, guys, and 4th of July, and I gotta get started on my laminator, so, my Amy's is gonna be here, and it says call, right?
6:30.
It says pretty good, and if you watch my channel, check out this question number. Probably see I'll just sit back and give us and relax and give yourself a drink as well. Let's get started.
You getting your laminator on?
No. So good. I'll take my hand with this. It's paper, right?
Huh?
Paper, right?
Paper.
What's it called?
What?
This one.
Laminated paper.
Laminated paper. Laminated paper. It's called laminated paper. Laminator paper. One, two, three. Tell me something, neck hurts, it's really bad.
What?
Tell me, cat, his neck hurts.
It is.
Yep, and I think he's got the boo boo on his neck.
When he comes in, I'll look at it.
Oh yeah, you can.
Mm-hmm.
Food, Lily. What? Oh. I'm trying to work on my name, you know. I'm sorry. Sorry, girl.
It's alright.
I'm watching 2, 3, 4, 5.
She needs a friend.
What's it? Six, seven. No, 7. Just turn on my laminator on. And laminator get nice and hot. Use a trash can when I cut them.
Good,
You put this in the trash?
No, I gotta get it to me. Richard.
My sister lost her husband in Prague. Took her a long time just to be able to cry. Now she's dead. She's dead. She's dead. She's dead. She's dead.
Let's see if it has some more pictures of Monty Pops. Let's see what else I got. Here comes now and three. Got them here. Scissors and cut pictures. Okay. I'm going to have the dummy scissors so I need to cut those pictures. Mom, that's good news. Mom.
Yeah, now what, you go out and help me with the pump.
Okay, I will. Lemonator, and it's hot.
Jeffrey, I spent the night.
See, I'm worn up.
Are you so mad at me? I could have smothered in the bed.
That's it.
I'm sorry. I promise I'll never do anything like that again.
Don't be too sorry, Serena.
Yeah,
it was quiet this afternoon. I've spent it.
Good night, Jeffrey.
Good night, man.
Thank you. And so
time for the movie.
Oh, it's ready.
Unable to give her details about what was happening. The laminator.
Tristan Valentine
many times before ran out of their bedroom and attacked the child without warning. It took three adults several agonizing minutes to pull the dog away.
Laminator. All pictures. Pictures. Okay, when the laminator comes out, it comes out good.
Hold this.
They discovered he has no tendon, ligament, or nerve damage. When they told you that, did you think that almost like a miracle?
I did. I honestly did.
The family had to put the pit bull down because of what happened and the dog's injuries. They're healing from all the trauma because little Tristan is healing. Tuesday afternoon, Christine walked around the corner to see him walking with his nurses for the first time since the attack.
I was on my knees on the floor, just sobbing because I did not
expect. Tristan had a long road to recovery, but his mom says she is just thankful that he'll be here to celebrate his next birthday.
Count down to.
And then Mike Campbell, News Center stop.
Elaine told us they have two large King Corso dogs at home. Tristan is showing no fear, already asking, but he can go home to see the canines.
Nobody
got hurt in this crash. This was on 75 at Wagner Ford in Harrison Township. Here's what our crew saw in Sky 7 as well, as that car was flipped on its side this afternoon. It's still not clear what caused that crash. And I want to give you a live look outside. Sunny today on this 4th of July. Hot as well. Temperatures, it feels, but definitely above 90 degrees.
Bring to James Brown.
4th of July Festival. There's food trucks, James
Brown,
and fun activities, and of course, fireworks.
James
Center 7's
Brown
has been at the festival all day.
I know James Brown also.
It's probably perfect. It's under a tree. We got a breeze. It's at the end of the parade route. She told me, other than snagging a spot in the shade, we always bring water. The little ones especially need that. And we have our sunglasses and hats, and that's about it. 10-year-old Caden Bernardi told me he showed up prepared for the heat as well. He even washed off his festive face paint so he didn't sweat it off.
I didn't want to look weird during it. And I'm sweating out here. It's a nice day out. That's why I got my water.
If the shade isn't doing its job, then come over here to the dunk tank. It'll cool you off.
What are you doing?
Did that cool you off at all?
Yeah,
I didn't do it wrong.
It's really hot out today.
Kraus walked the parade with his Boy Scout troop.
Dunk tank.
Dunk tank. This morning.
Comes out good.
Find some shade to take a break. If you become lightheaded or dizzy, certainly sit down, relax.
He said if it gets to a point where it's an emergency, you can call 911 or look for the fire ATV that will be circulating the park.
Enjoy the 4th of July and just be careful. Have a good time. Don't overdo it. Find some shade. Drink lots of fluid.
Watching over everyone. Coming up tonight at 6, I talked to some people who told me the way the world is now, they are more than happy to have police.
How's it wrong?
Four.
Alright, Taylor and Keith did not get people away from the Maricana Festival in Centerville. Just wrapped up about 5 minutes ago. Every year, organizers say upwards of 75,000 people show up here.
Come out.
I've been in the Centerville area for 17 years. We've come to it for 17 straight years, so...
town.
Yeah, before the parade, there was a 5K run, and later on, a car show. I drove through the parade route late last night, and I have to admit, I lost count of the number of porta-potties they had set out, which is obviously a good thing when you have 75,000 people attending.
Really?
Yeah, take it to Enid. It had its 4th of July parade this afternoon. And
yeah, well, 4th of July parade is coming.
Senior road to be able to check things out. The parade's
yep.
in schools.
4th of July parade is coming.
Fireworks show.
Right there.
That's going to be in Benham. Where?
And fireworks to check out again.
In Benham, I don't have a 4th of July parade.
That's going to have one.
Fireworks, so. You going to watch fireworks?
No, that's really not. I'll see what that one. I'll see what that one.
Smith was out of his vehicle trying to put down stop sticks.
Don't even mess with me.
5
you
years.
Give me that form.
He was 33 years old. His funeral is Friday. And Governor DeWine signed Ohio's two-year budget. The governor's office.
That's busted.
Picture signing early this morning. The budget includes almost $3 billion in income tax cuts, funding for universal school vouchers.
That picture is busted.
Plan, which would ban cities from regulating tobacco sales. His office said he will talk more about that budget tomorrow. And the governor asked the president for a disaster declaration for East Palestine and that toxic trade derailment. The governor thinks the disaster declaration would ensure the community gets all resources available from the state and federal government. Up to this point, Norfolk Southern...
You need to let up.
Carry on.
A new video here at 5 o'clock of a canine helping Middletown police take down a robbery suspect.
Middletown police, what does that mean?
Kroger grabbed some items and handed a note to the cashier demanding money.
What does that mean?
And he threatened to shoot them yesterday.
They live in Middletown.
He's in the Butler County jail this afternoon. Police think he was part of other robberies in that area. You can see right there the canine going after him. As police are following in body camera videos, the dog takes him down.
Money Pucks, Paul Patrol, Paul Patrol, Money Pucks.
Ambulance chasing out of town lawyers are
Money Pucks.
Trying to get your injury case. Let's keep it in our community. Hire your top rated hometown attorney. We'll fight hard to get you maximum cash in minimum time. Call 937-222-2222. Durability and value. For a limited time, get free installation on any NatureStone garage floor. Call or visit NatureStone.com to schedule your free cost estimate. Spots are filling up quickly, so act now. It's not just the floor, but it's NatureStone. These documents protect our fundamental freedoms. But a constitutional amendment this August called it permanently remove our rights from the Ohio Constitution. Issue 1 ends majority rule in Ohio.
That one? Pictures?
What's bugging you? Ants, spiders, bees, cockroaches, even rodents? At home or at work? Exterminate all termite and pest control has the best trained bug techs in the business. I will devise a plan to get rid of your pests. Go to exterminateall.com to schedule a free estimate.
At Bathfitter, every quality bath starts with quality people. Our consultants help fit your style with hundreds of design options. Our installers help fit your schedule with work completed in as little as a day. Our manufacturing team helps fit your standards with custom baths that are guaranteed for life. When you can trust the people who create your new bath, it just fits.
Bathfitter.
Call today for your free quote and receive no interest until 2028. Dunn's Memorials has been handcrafting memorials made from American granite for over 156 years. Our exclusive partnership with Rock of Ages Granite means your family will have access to the best memorial products from the United States available today. And all our memorials are backed by a perpetual trust warranty. Don't leave your loved one's legacy to just anyone.
We need to
memorial experts at Dunn's Memorials. Visit one of our 6 locations to learn more about our American-made products or visit our website, doddsmemorials.com.
A former Ocean Gate employee said he thinks the Titanic submarine implosion was done on purpose. The implosion killed all 5 people on the sub while it was heading to the Titanic wreckage last month. The New Yorker reported a worker wrote an email saying he was concerned the CEO would kill himself and others as a way to boost his own ego.
Edwards.
2018,
Everest,
so 5 years ago,
Lockridge
inspected the areas every day. Emotion. Awesome. The balanced bags, you had mounting bolts threatening to rupture.
Good job, cutting them.
Everything that could go wrong was sort of going wrong. The employee had legal problems with OceanGate after filing for a wrongful termination. He said the company fired him for raising concerns about the sub's safety. Mm. See right here, the deputy worked to break a window. He got the woman out of the car just as flames took over. And in Northern Ohio, a similar rescue. Chester Township police officers dragged the driver away from that burning car. Officer said the man was unconscious when they got to him, and then they got him to the hospital. Travelers, folks unfortunately across the country are dealing with flight delays and cancellations this 4th of July. According to FlightAware, airlines canceled or delayed 1,000 flights today. They blame most of this on severe weather. Today, storms are moving through the Northeast, as well as the plains.
I'm hoping that I traveled the right time here, and I'm hoping that going back is the right time as well.
AAA predicted more than 4 million Americans would be flying over the 4th of July holiday. And more than 43 million people drove. AAA said the best time to travel is today, anytime after 6 o'clock, and anytime before 2 p.m. tomorrow. From 3 to 6 tomorrow, those folks on the roads expect lots of traffic. And in Chicago last week, I paid $4.30 for a gallon of gas. But overall, AAA said drivers are paying a dollar less this year than last in many parts of the country. New Center 7 found some places around the Miami Valley selling gas below $3. You can see right there, $2.97 at the Clark Station in Piqua. The average price across Ohio, $3.27. Shelby County has the cheapest gas at $3.07. Most expensive there in Butler County at $3.29. And to celebrate July 4th, Sheetz convenience stores are offering gas for $1.76 a gallon. Recently, Sheetz started building and opening stores here in Ohio. It has more than 600 locations in the Mid-Atlantic and Midwest. Keep in mind, you can always find the lowest gas prices near where you are on our WHIO News app. All you have to do is click on Pump Patrol. Strong storms today got in the way of Nathan's famous 4th of July International Hot Dog Eating Contest in New York City. But as Astrid Martinez reports, organizers were able to reset the stage and pull off the contest.
As thousands braving storms in Brooklyn, New York, learned the men's division of Nathan's hot dog eating contest was delayed, then temporarily called off.
We woke up really early today on the holiday. We were really excited, so it's pretty disappointing.
She's gonna try to fix my door.
You're talking about the damn washer?
Not yet.
Sir, I haven't been out to the pump yet.
Please, do that now.
Oh.
Mom, it'll take you 15 minutes.
Go turn the water on.
I want to do it before Richard gets
here.
I think one, because goats eat anything. Two, goat, acronym for greatest of all time, although I didn't live up to that, I don't think.
So again, if you missed our conversation yesterday, it was like 3 minutes, and what'd you do?
actually went to the West Milton fireworks show. That was amazing. Now, clouds and rain, not seeing too much of that over here, but across the Northeast and parts of the Midwest, we're seeing some showers, even a severe thunderstorm warning now in South Jersey. But the Miami Valley's pretty quiet. You do see some showers and thunderstorms knocking on the door of Cincinnati and Covington, Kentucky, and even a little bit of activity here in Franklin County, but otherwise, we're pretty dry. I mentioned that shower kind of popping up here in Wayne County. You're also seeing a little bit of cloud cover, but you're also seeing a lot of sunshine. So it really is a beautiful 4th of July. And so hopefully you're taking part in that this evening. 87 degrees, the temperature right now. The cloud cover is being reported right now at the airport. But as you can see, at least looking out of Springfield, there's a lot of blue sky with some calm and variable winds. So it should feel pretty comfortable. Over the next several days, we're going to be, well, hot to start Wednesday.
Well,
but then we will trend a little bit cooler heading into the weekend and then perhaps even the 70s next week. That is cooler than average because we're typically in the mid to upper 80s this time of year. So today
it's
a bit on the hot and humid side, but it should be a little bit better. Now, the future cast does show the chance of a stray shower, perhaps even a stray rumble of thunder. Nothing like what we saw yesterday where we saw some really good scattered showers and thunderstorms across the region. So here's a look at 7 o'clock. You can see some of that still remaining. Here's a look at 9 o'clock right before the sun sets, and it's pretty dry. And 10 o'clock, I would say between 9 and 10, where some of these fireworks shows are, we're looking pretty good. And heading into Wednesday, a little bit different story. Have a better chance of a stray shower or thunderstorm. But today does look to be pretty dry, so that's good news if you have stuff planned.
All right, let's walk.
Humid tomorrow again. The temperature's about 90 degrees. A better chance of rain overall.
Last picture.
Thursday. And then Saturday looking actually pretty dry before we see the chance of some isolated storms returning on Sunday.
Where are you, Mom?
A little cooler than average.
Scary moments at a July 4th parade in Ohio here when a parade float ran over a little girl.
Hold on, let me. Here, hope you guys enjoy.